Hello, and welcome back to the Halloween special of RTN Tonight, Glassboro's favorite mid-afternoon late-night talk show. I'm Parker Bennick.
And I'm Caitlin Kowalski. As always, we've got a great show today, so let's get started with the news.
This past Friday, the hierarchy of power in the DC universe officially changed with the release of Dwayne Johnson's Black Adam, and the responses have been mixed. The movie's currently rocking a 39% critics score on Rotten Tomatoes, with the audience score being significantly higher at 90%. Without a doubt, the memes have definitely boosted the audience score. Either that or The Rock is bribing moviegoers with free Zoa energy drinks and Terramana tequila.
Now for some news hitting home. A woman in Philadelphia felt like there was something in her eye. That something turned out to be 23 daily disposable contacts stuck under her eyelid. Dr. Katrina Caverra of California Eye Associates was shocked to find what looked like a pancake stack under her eyelid. "I've never seen this before," Caverra stated. Luckily, after the contacts were removed, the woman didn't have an infection. "I'm still very confused and wondering how she didn't realize there's a stack of cards under her eyelid."
On Friday, October 14th, New Jersey death metal band Lorna Shore unleashed their fourth studio album titled Pain Remains, and I've got to say, it's one of the best albums I've heard this year. It's so good that whenever I blast it in my room, my neighbors viciously slam on my door and scream in the hallways, just like in the songs. Whenever I play it in my car, my friends are completely speechless because of how much they love the music. And whenever I play it in my earbuds, well, I just cry. In all seriousness, it's a great album. I don't have any more punchlines. I just think I wanted an opportunity to talk about it without my roommates telling me to shut up.
A San Francisco bakery created its own special treat for every Star Wars fan this past weekend. Pan Solo is a hunk of bread, literally, made to resemble Han Solo. Hannah Lee Pervin and her mother, Kathleen Pervin, co-owners of One House Bakery in Valencia, California, started the weeks-long project. The two used wood and two types of dough with a higher sugar content to create the life-size sculpture. The sculpture is now located about half an hour's drive north of San Francisco for display.
Carroll County, Indiana has been in the news recently after police confirmed that a pet kangaroo is on the loose in the area. If you saw the last episode, you already know what I think about Australian wildlife, and with good reason. Seriously, those things wake up and choose violence every single day. And I don't know if anyone's ever seen a kangaroo up close before, but they are absolutely jacked. I gotta get their workout routine. Anyway, as a result of the police statement, residents are being warned not to pick up hitchhikers that they suspect may in fact be kangaroos.
Mexico City broke a Guinness World Record when nearly 3,935 people took part in a 45-minute fitness class. Organizers said more than 4,000 people bounced on trampolines during the class. 130 participants were disqualified, leaving the total of 3,935. The event was witnessed by a Guinness adjuster who confirmed the record was set. "I truly do wonder how you get disqualified while jumping on a trampoline."
I just thought of this now. Going off of that story, Kate, I have a question. You know that trick where you get a group of people on one trampoline and you can all jump at the same time and bounce someone super high? Now imagine that with 4,000 people on a single trampoline. I suspect that could be the secret to intergalactic travel.
A power outage that affects 1,953 customers in Oregon had people going a little nuts over the reason for the outage. A squirrel. PGE said the animal was to blame for the outage, but the specifics of how the animal did it remain unknown. East Salem lost power due to the incident at 10:42 a.m., and the power was restored by 12 p.m. Officials say everyone was safe during the occurrence, well, except for the squirrel, because he was most definitely electrocuted. We're now going to take a quick break and watch a scare.
What's up, RTN Tonight? I'm here scaring my buddy. Boo!
I gotta go to Lowe's.
Bro, I told you to get scared. Back to the desk.
Wow, what a scare. Now I'm joined by a very special guest here tonight, Barnacle Boy. Now, unfortunately, he is not here for all the right reasons. We are talking about a very sentimental thing to him tonight, his former breakup with Merman. How do you feel about that?
Thank you so much for having me, Kate. It's been hard, breaking up the duo. Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. so many fantastic adventures, but sometimes you have to go solo, you know?
Can I just ask, what happened? Because the last time we saw you guys, you were madly in love. Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy? The love story of a lifetime? I mean, what happened?
Well, sometimes a barnacle boy becomes a barnacle man. In that moment, you need to choose for yourself where you go next. You know?
That really hurts my soul because you guys literally were my inspiration in my relationship. So sorry to hear that.
Well, it's okay.
Well, now we're gonna throw it back to Parker over at the desk to interview another one of our very special guests.
Thanks, Kate. Once again, I'm Parker Bennick, and I'm joined by another special guest, Peter LaFleur. Peter, how are you doing today?
Doing great. That's how are awesome. You doing, Parker?
I'm doing good, too. So it's my understanding that you were in a film called Dodgeball. Is that correct?
Well, it wasn't a film. It's more of a sport.
Oh, okay.
We competed against, as you know, the Globo Gym.
Okay.
White Goodman, as we all know, is a terrible person and doesn't show a lot of good enthusiasm when it comes to different people playing dodgeball. So I'm just out here supporting dodgeball and supporting people.
Awesome. But what's your favorite thing, to talk more about the game, what's your favorite thing about the sport of dodgeball?
Just say the competitiveness of it and the fun at the same time. I remember a couple months back I threw a dodgeball at a little kid's face and, you know, although they did cry, it was fun and they had a great time later on. I did win at the end, but they had an amazing time.
Thanks, Peter. On that note, I think we should head back to Kate with our next guest.
Thank you, Parker. And now I'm joined by another very special guest, Harry the Bear. Harry, my first question is, how far of a travel did you have to come here? Coming from the woods and everything like that? I feel like it's been a long commute for you.
It was pretty hard getting here, especially trying to cross the Jersey Turnpike. There was like a big commotion. Like I was just trying to get to the other side of the street and then all of a sudden like all these people are like yelling at me, saying I shouldn't be in the street or whatever.
Yeah, because bears usually are allowed in the street then.
Yeah,
that's what I
they
thought.
Should
and
be.
Also I did want to ask you, you brought your own very special guest, I see.
Yeah, this is my fish. His name is Jeremy.
Oh, wow. So you don't eat fish? Or is it just Jeremy you don't
just
eat?
Just Jeremy, he's special.
Oh, okay. So yeah. Other than that, what are you related to Winnie the Pooh also? That's what I did want to get out of my
no,
chest.
No, me and Winnie the Pooh, we kind of have some beef there, but...
What beef?
Well, you see, like, Winnie the Pooh, he, like, once took all of my honey, and I, like... Nah.
Okay, and with that, we're gonna wrap it up and throw it back to Parker at the desk.
Thanks, Kate. And keeping with the trend of animal guests, I'm joined today by a lemur.
Hello.
How you doing today?
You know, I'm pretty okay. I'm actually happy that you invited me to come on here, Parker. There's a couple words I gotta get out from my lemur community back
sure.
home. All right, so I'm gonna start off by saying this. King Julian, right, from Madagascar?
Yeah.
You know, it was crazy. A lot of people don't know this. He was supposed to get, you know, me, my brothers and sisters back at the Bronx Zoo up to Madagascar. Like, you know, when the movie came out.
Mm-hmm.
We still haven't got there yet.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's getting pretty hectic over there. Like, a lot of people are really mad, you know, including me, of course. But, yeah, no, we don't really mess with King Julian down in the Bronx.
Noted. I mean, going to be honest, I don't have any other questions for you, Mr. Lemur, but I do appreciate the PSA that you gave for all of our lemur advocates out there. So we're going to give it back to Kate for our final guest, for her.
Thank you, Parker. And we are joined by another very, very special guest, specifically to me, Princess Tiana.
Thank you.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Kate. How are you?
I'm wonderful. And I do see you brought your prince with you, Prince Naveen.
Yes, I had to bring my man along with
yes.
me to support me, you know.
You guys honestly make such a cute couple. I just want to put that out there.
Thank you so, so much. You know, he's just so precious to me. I've seen him through some things. He's seen me through some things, so... Bringing him here today really, really meant a lot to me.
So I do want to ask, considering you're a princess and he's a frog, how does this relationship work?
You know, he's just always by my side, supporting me, you know, all the time. We're together. I have this really, really great skincare routine, you know, trying to avoid the warts and like that. Right. But, you know, he's like my right hand right now. He's on my left shoulder. But, you know, I'm running through restaurants with him and, you know, making the beignets, all that good stuff. He's just very, very supportive.
I love to hear that for you.
Thank you.
Well,
thank
with
you.
That, we are going to throw it back to Parker for the very last guest of the night.
Thanks, Kate. And I'm joined by the final guest of the night, Darth Yall. How you doing, Darth?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
I'm good. I see that you're with the Empire and not the Rebels. Is there anything you have to say about that?
Not really. I was never really the good guy. Like, I always dressed in black. They took me in. I didn't have a lightsaber. I had a kill a guy for this one.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But it's pretty cool. They took me in, like, pretty easily, so they're nice. They're
fairly accepting in the
Empire. Yeah, they're nicer than they seem in the movies.
Okay.
Yeah, they're very accepting.
Yes. So we're actually going to go.
Join any time, actually. We take new members.
That's great. I might have to sign up. So we're actually going to go into the game segment No Cap to round out our show.
Okay.
So I'm going to start the timer right after the first question, okay?
Okay.
So our first question, these are going to go rapid fire. What is the scariest monster?
Vampires.
What superpower would you want the most?
Invisibility.
Are ghosts real?
Yes.
Favorite Halloween movie?
Halloween.
Favorite Halloween song?
Here comes Halloween, here comes Halloween.
Favorite flower?
A rose?
Is chocolate better on a Tuesday or a Thursday?
Thursday.
Would you rather meet Danny DeVito or George Washington?
Danny DeVito, come on.
47 or 85?
47 or 85? 85.
Musical chairs or silent ball?
Musical chairs.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good of a driver are you?
Pretty good. Oh, 10. Yeah, 10.
In a situation, would you ever back out of going forward if it was too fast?
No.
Favorite professional badminton team?
The professional badminters.
Favorite rock?
Like shiny ones.
Are birds robots or are they real?
They're robots. They're always watching.
Monkeys or tigers?
Tigers.
When is the perfect time to take out your Christmas decorations?
After Thanksgiving.
Do you like fireworks or do you like fireworks?
I like fireworks.
Cool.
I like.
What's up with clouds?
The puffy.
Yeah, that's true. And what show is better, RTN Tonight or literally anything else?
RTN Tonight.
And with that, we have a time of 1 minute and 13 seconds. So that's right. A great time, Darth Yall. Right. Thank you very much for being on the show. And thank you for watching. That rounds out the Halloween special for RTN Tonight. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.